with 12 penalty points by virtue of a clear round by Joe Fargus. 4 penalty points for Leslie Burr and 8 for Conrad Holmfeld. There she is, Melanie Smith, one of the great riders, a consistent show jumper. 35 years old, born in Tennessee, riding out of Litchfield, Connecticut now, and she's at the very far end of the course. This gives her an opportunity, actually, to look again at the course. They walk it once, the horse has never seen it before, and the start is to the left all the way to the opposite end, and the capacity crowd here, Bill, is giving her a very warm welcome. We hope that the crowd doesn't affect this horse, as we do for the whole field of 40, because they have been cheering not only for the American riders, but the other competitors as well.
Right, Chris, this is certainly one of the most consistent high-class combinations of horse and rider in the world. Melanie and Calypso have won everything, including the World Cup final, as she starts her course, and the audience for a moment quiets down. The situation is this. The British have an 8 and a 0 for 2 riders. They've got a discard score of 19. If their last rider goes clear, they could have 8. We've got 12 in the bank right now, and Melanie is working really on Conrad Holmfeld's score of 8. If Melanie can get around with a 0 penalty point score, or clear round, or 4 faults even, then you could discard Abdullah's score, and we would finish with 8, or conceivably even with 4.
Calypso, an 11-year-old bay gelding, Dutch bred, over at 5 now, on a slight angle. Now turning to 7.
7 is the first real question on the course. Melanie and Calypso have done this kind of thing so often and made it look so easy that I still have an awful lot of confidence in him. She hustles him a little bit out of there because he dwells just jumping into the two. It's not a two combination, it's a 3 strider. Now he comes to the gate in this long line to the water.
Now the water.
The water like nothing, steadies pretty well. She's got that lined up. And he jumps the big 11 oxer clearly.
Still clear. Melanie Smith of the United States on Calypso, now coming to the Redwood triple.
And it's a critical triple. He nails the in, nails the triple bar, nails the out. And coming to the last line, he's still clear, Chris.
Nice tempo, Melanie Smith and Calypso.
Melanie is a free swinger, I would say. There's no pressure that ever gets to her. Jumps the wall beautifully, sets him up for this two combination. This is tough. Jumps in.
Touched it.
Jumps out.
Down.
One more fence
one
to,
more
go.
To go.
And
you're looking at a
clear round for Melanie. The U.S. team finishes the first round with only 4 penalty points, and we're going to be in front. The U.S. team is going to be in front at the end of the first round, no matter what.
Now, after 40, well, nearing the 40 number ride, we have 4 clear rounds. Joe Fargus of the United States, Heidi Robiani of Switzerland, Timmy Grubb of Great Britain, and now Melanie Smith. All right. We'll be back with more at Santa Anita on a beautiful day. The cheers for Melanie Smith. We'll be back after this.
I'm here in the warm-up area with Melanie Smith, who's just come out of the ring with a clear round. Very few clear rounds today, Melanie. It was a thrill. You really gave us a thrill.
Thanks. It just felt great. It really was so much fun riding out there. I thought I would be nervous, but I was really having a blast.
Tell me, you know, we as a 3-day event rider, we talk about how courageous our little horses have to be and how much heart they have, how much courage they have, and what terrific athletes they are. But certainly they have to be superb athletes and tremendously courageous in the show jump arena today.
They do. They have to have tremendous talent, tremendous courage, and tremendous intelligence to go in there with that bigger crowd. We're not used to showing in front of that many people, and of course the home American audience is so enthusiastic, and it takes a lot for a horse to really concentrate on his job and not get distracted, and for the riders too.
Melanie, the poles are lighter than they usually are. Is that creating a problem? Is that one of the reasons why there's so few clear rounds?
I believe so, because usually for a big course like this you want to really ride strongly to the jumps, and you can't ride too strongly because they knock very easily. So it's a combination of knowing just how much you can ride to them and just how much you need to back off.
Great. Well, Melanie, you did a terrific job, and thank you very much for coming to see us. And now we'll go back to you, Chris.
Thank you very much, Tad. And of course, Melanie Smith will be seen later on, because this is the first round. It's nearing completion, and at this point, the United States